Hi everyone, LJ Aguinaga here with LJ Realties, and this week I'm going to talk about the differences between a passive investment and an active investment. Simply put, a passive investment is a vehicle where you do not have to put any to much work every single month or quarter, and you will receive some sort of payout, cash flow from it. I like to refer to this as mailbox money. The first example I'll give is a dividend paying stock. Every quarter, just by owning the stock, you're going to get a dividend deposited in your account or a check in the mail. Another example would be cash flowing real estate. So if you own a condo, triplex, sixplex, etc., after you receive all the rents, if you have cash flow left over after paying the expenses, therefore you have mailbox money coming in. Some people will argue, well, LJ, that's not really passive investment because you might have to deal with maintenance and complaints from tenants, etc. You're right. However, if you have a management company in place and therefore you are really just receiving the cash flows from it and don't have to deal with day-to-day operations, that is very much passive investment. The second thing you can look at is what is active investment income. So active investment income is something that you are very much involved in. Doing a BRRRR strategy, if you will, would be very active. I take a very active role by going in, negotiating with tenants, hiring contractors, overseeing the construction period, re-renting the units, negotiating with banks. It's very active income. Flipping a home, same thing, very active. You go in, you source the deal, you strip the property, you renovate it entirely, then you put it back on market, etc., etc. These are examples of active income. If you have a business, if you work a job, these are all active income because they require you to be there every day or weekly, monthly, etc., in order for you to get paid. The beauty of passive income is that that is what will eventually make you be financially free. This is what will allow you to be on the beach one day with your family or vacationing wherever you'd like and still have income coming in. In order to be able to retire at some point and maintain the same quality of life that you're used to having, you need vehicles of passive investment income in order to get you there. Therefore, the big takeaway here is if you want to be retired earlier, if you want to maintain the same quality of life and not have to worry about a nest egg that is continuously shrinking, you need to make sure that you have passive investment vehicles available to you for your retirement so that you can really enjoy the rest of your life. Thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you next week. Take care.